cross in endless rest. Ye patriarchs and prophets blessed. Alleluia, alleluia. Ye holy 12, ye martyrs strong. All saints triumph and raise the song. In gladness let us sing, all heaven's anthems echoing. Alleluia, alleluia. To God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit, three in one. Alleluia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all
and
with your spirit. Let us call to mind our shortcomings and failures. Ask God's pardon and forgiveness for the worthy celebration of this most holy Eucharist. Lord Jesus, you came to call us sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again, glory to judge the living and the dead. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all saints. Bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal. 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Established it upon the river.
Lord, this is your people that longs to see your face.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord and established it upon the rivers? For he hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is a race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of God of Jacob.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure, as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord, be with you, with your spirit. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate the solemnity of All Saints. Why do we have this celebration? holy men and women who live an outstanding Christian life, the church canonizes them as saints. But there are many men and women who really live a holy life according to the values of the gospel, even though the church officially may not have canonized them. And then today, we commemorate all those holy men and women who lived out the values of the gospel in a very radical way. And for our reflection, we have one of the most beautiful passages from the Gospel of Matthew. Matthew begins his gospel by giving us the genealogy. He's setting the stage to say that he is going to talk about the promised one, the Messiah, the one who is going to fulfill all the laws and the prophets. Moses went up to Mount Zion, the holy mountain. God gives him 10 commandments. So those 10 commandments were to help the people to live a life so that they can walk in the ways of God. Jesus, the second Moses, he goes up on the mountain. The disciples and the people gathers around him. And now he's going to pour out his heart, inviting everyone to live a life according to his principles and values so that people could walk in the ways of God. He begins by saying, blessed. Now, what's the meaning of blessed? You know, in English, we use it in many ways. You know, often we would say, you know, I am blessed with a lot of good things. I am blessed with good health. I am blessed with good family. You know, that's a blessing about what we have. But when the scripture says about being blessed, or when Jesus said blessed, the Greek word used is called makarios. Makarios means happiness or blissful or satisfied or contented. You know, none of these words exactly doesn't give the meaning, but the real meaning is the happiness that comes from the Creator. We can say it's a state of being. Now Jesus says about 8 beatitudes. So which should serve as a foundation how to be a disciple of Jesus. Let's take a couple of them. The first one, he says, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Now, when Jesus says poor in spirit, he's not talking about material poverty. Now, as we know, poverty is not, you know, it is not, what do you call it? It's not anything positive. It is something negative. God never wants anyone to be poor. But what Jesus means here is, being poor would mean being in need of. So all those people who are in need of God or who seek the Lord always, they are being blessed by God. And then he promises that they will inherit the heaven. And then secondly, he says, blessed, the second one he says, blessed are the, let's say, blessed are the merciful. They will be shown mercy. You know, Jesus showed the real face of God. God, our God is merciful and compassionate. You know, when we pray the Our Father, we ask God to forgive our sins as we forgive the sins of others. So Jesus says, when we forgive those who sin against us, we become like God. Our God is compassionate, merciful. He forgives the sins of his people. So when we forgive those who wrong us, we become like God. And he says, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. You know, Jesus begins his public ministry by inviting people to repentance. So here, mourn means, so those who mourn over their sins, those who mourn over the sins of the world, Jesus says, they will be blessed and they will be comforted. You know, Jesus came to invite everyone to a true conversion. A true conversion to turn away from the sins and walk in the ways of God. And he says, blessed are those who thirst and hunger for righteousness. You know, God wants that this world be established on justice and peace. And when ungodly things happen in our societies, so as Christians, we have a responsibility to invite people or, you know, serve as conscious to the society. Not in a violent manner, but in a very peaceful manner. So thus, Jesus pronounced, you know, eight times that we will be blessed, those who walk in his ways. And as we commemorate today, the solemnities of All Saints. Saints are the one who lived out these Beatitudes. So these Beatitudes are not just, it's not just ideals, not just concept to learn. Jesus invited his disciples to all his followers to live out these values. And whoever lives out these values will grow more closer towards God. You know, that is a reason for the incarnation. John would say, he came so that we may have life, life in abundance. And you and I, we are invited to become saints. Every Christian, the vocation is to become a saint. That means to live out the values of the gospel. And as we commemorate, as we celebrate this solemnity of All Saints, let's seek the powerful intercession of all the saints, that we may, through their powerful intercession, we may imitate the person of Jesus Christ and live out the values of the gospel. Please rise. We shall pray together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that's visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. Arose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. To God the Father Almighty, dear sisters and brothers, may every prayer of our heart be directed, for his will is that all humanity should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth.
We pray that the communion of saints will intercede for the church that they so faithfully served. May their intercession guide the Holy Father and all church leaders to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our nation, as people will be choosing their leaders on November 3rd, that the Holy Spirit will guide us in being faithful citizens without compromising our discipleship and service of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parish, that we will strive to be people of the Beatitudes, seeking God's presence and joy in all things. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, ravaged by pandemic, fires, civil unrest, ethical confusion, and environmental stress, that we act as people of hope and love, cultivating healing in all things. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick or homebound may be comforted and assured of our ongoing prayer for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family, relations, and friends who have died, that they may rejoice in the communion of saints forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the faithful departed, especially for Benji Marsalek, whose memory this Mass is being celebrated. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. After the All Saints celebration, the next day is the celebration of all the faithful departed. So today in a special way, we pray for all the departed members of our parish family from last year. And a reminder, November 2nd is All Souls Day, and we have a Mass at 8:30 a.m. And then as I read out the names, Ken will light a candle for in each person's memory. You can be seated. Benjamin A. Marsalek. Margaret Violet. Rosalind Rose Brandenburg. Andre Cardinal. Dorothy Roscos. Frank Marsalek. Richard Jurowski. Victoria Vicky Kolig. Lois Darlene Baslow. Harold R. Machinik. Roman J. Shibala. Doris M. Fila. Alphonse Ellie Sabrinsky. And Edward Slavik. May the souls of all faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Oh Lord, standing on.
search my heart. And you know when I sit and when I stand.
That's...
Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh, Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in waves everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I find you.
Precious sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father, may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrim, advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church, through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with a multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, holy, the Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Oh,
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, William our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace and joy of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already in my heart, and unite myself to you completely. Please do not let me ever be separated from you. Amen. Are there any cars in the parking lot that are listening to 90.1 and would like to receive communion? Honk your horn when you see the Eucharistic minister exit the elevator doors.
Are they the poor in spirit? Theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they, full of sorrow, they shall be consoled. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed
let's Rejoice and be glad, yours is the kingdom, shine for all to see. Rejoice and be glad, blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice.
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland through Christ our Lord. Amen. We shall pray together. Pray to Saint Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
A couple of reminders before the final blessings. So Monday, November 2nd, is All Souls Day. So we will have a mass in the morning at the usual time, 8:30 a.m. Everyone is welcome to participate. And we have the annual finance report. The ushers will have them. So if anyone interested, please help yourself with a copy. And November 3rd, as you know, is the day of election. And then we'll be specially praying for our nation. So we'll have mass as usual at 8:30 a.m., followed by Eucharistic adoration begins at 9 a.m. And all day, and we will conclude with benediction at 8 p.m. So at the both entrance or exits, whatever you call it. So we have sign-up sheets. So please take a moment. And if you could come and spend like 30 minutes or an hour or more, so we would welcome that. And then if you have not signed up, so please walk in anytime. The church doors will be open anytime. Come in, maybe spend 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Now we have, leading up to the election day, we have a special prayer. We will pray together. God, our Father and Creator, we acknowledge that you are our God and there is no other. We acknowledge your sovereign control over all things. We confess that we are experiencing fear and anxiety, but you are greater than those things that come against us. We love you and we believe what you say is true and can be depended upon. We repent of not loving you and your people better. We seek your forgiveness and wise counsel, not just for now, but for always. We pray for the upcoming 2020 presidential election and ask for peace, safety for all, and your guidance. We declare you are our peace. We seek your will and not our own, knowing that all things work together for our good and your glory, because we are called and loved by you. We declare that the government rests on your shoulders. We decree that you, as our sovereign God, a loving Father, know all things. We put our trust in you alone. We pray that you turn the hearts of your people back to you. We pray for your will be done. We ask all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, Savior, King, and Redeemer. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. So thank you everyone for partaking in this Eucharist, and we also thank those who join us through the live stream and those who participate later through the YouTube. Have a great weekend.